Let us consider the transformation of four vectors that represent the vertices of a unit square. These vertices are defined as a at 0, 0, b at 1, 0, c at 1, 1, and d at 0, 1. The area of this square is 1 unit. Now, consider a matrix labeled A with entries 1, 2, 2, and 1. When this matrix is applied to transform the square, the resulting vertices become A prime at 0, 0, B prime at 1, 2, C prime at 3, 3, and D prime at 2, 1. The transformed geometry is now a parallelogram with an area of 3, which is 3 times the area of the original square. Additionally, if you trace the vertices starting from A to B to C and to D in the original square, the trace goes counterclockwise. However, after the transformation, tracing the vertices of the parallelogram from A prime to B prime to C prime and to D prime proceeds in a clockwise direction. Another critical observation is that there exists a matrix that can reverse this transformation. Specifically, the inverse of matrix A, which is calculated as negative 1/3, 2/3, 2/3, and negative 1/3, can bring the parallelogram back to its original square. Let us now consider another example with a different transformation matrix. Suppose we apply a matrix labeled B with entries 1, 1, 1, and 1 to the original square. After the transformation, all four vertices align into a single line. In fact, the vertices B prime and D prime coincide, reducing the area of the transformed geometry to 0. This means that the transformation collapses the square into a lower dimension. It is clear that this transformation cannot be reversed because the same output point corresponds to two different original vertices. This violates the definition of a function, making it impossible to define a reverse mapping. All the phenomena we have observed so far, and many more that occur when transforming vectors by multiplying by matrices, can be explained by a powerful measure of a matrix called the determinant. In essence, the determinant determines these crucial characteristics of a matrix, which is why it is aptly named. The determinant is mathematically defined as a scalar value that encapsulates key geometric properties of a transformation. For a 2x2 matrix with entries A, B, C, and D, the determinant is calculated as A times D minus B times C. The absolute value of the determinant reveals how much the area is scaled during the transformation. A negative determinant signifies a change in orientation, such as a shift from counterclockwise to clockwise tracing. A determinant of 0 indicates that the transformation collapses the geometry into a lower dimension, rendering the matrix non-invertible. For instance, let's examine a matrix with entries 3, 4, 2, and 1. The determinant of this matrix is computed as 3 times 1 minus 4 times 2, which equals negative 5. The negative sign reflects a change in orientation, while the magnitude of 5 shows that the area is scaled by a factor of 5. As another example, consider a matrix with entries 2, 0, 0, and 3. The determinant is calculated as 2 times 3 minus 0 times 0, which equals 6. Here, the determinant shows that the area is scaled by a factor of 6, and since the determinant is positive, there is no change in orientation. To summarize, the determinant is a fundamental scalar quantity that provides profound insights into the behavior of the matrices. In subsequent lessons, we will explore determinants of matrices with dimensions greater than 2x2, exploring their properties and applications in more depth. Determinants help us understand scaling, orientation, and invertibility in transformations, and they serve as indispensable tools for solving advanced linear algebra problems. Mastering determinants is essential for unlocking the deeper geometric and algebraic structure within linear algebra.